agents, please report. The Octonauts and the Rainforest Rescue.
This old map isn't making any sense at all. Maybe I can get a better look from higher up.
Hello, Min.
Oh, Inky.
How are things in the Amazon rainforest?
I wish you could see this place for yourself.
I've been exploring the four different layers of the rainforest. I was at the bottom, the forest floor, which is the darkest and dampest layer, where millions of insects live among the leaves that fall from the layers above. And now I'm here in the understory,
where it's warm, damp, and sheltered with lots of shade.
It's the perfect place for jaguars, snakes, and frogs.
Fascinating.
Above me is the canopy, the leafy tops of the trees. It's sunny, breezy, and wet, and home to more creatures than any other layer,
like sloths and howler monkeys.
And all the way at the top is the emergent layer, where only the tallest trees can reach. This layer gets the most sunlight, the most rain, and the most wind.
Birds like eagles and vultures live up there. But there's something strange going on here, Inky.
Ooh! It seems something strange is going on here, too.
Howdy, Professor. Just going for a little test drive.
Ah, yes. Now, where were we, Min? Something strange in the rainforest.
Yes, this river is missing entirely.
Oh, a missing river. Are those howler monkey calls?
I think so. It sounds like they're pretty close.
Strange. Howler monkeys are supposed to live in the canopy near the tops of the trees.
So why would they be all the way down here by me in the understory?
Oh, careful, Min. Howlers are aggressive and they don't like guests.
I better go. I'll call you later.
Hey, this is our territory.
Oh, sorry, I'm just passing through.
Oh, yes. But if we let you pass, then we must let everyone pass. Then they start eating all our leaves, trample our branches. So, with my apologies, we must chase you away.
Wait! Why are you down here in the understory? Shouldn't you be way up there in the canopy?
Oh, we go where there's food and water. So now, this is our new territory. So you need to leave.
Are you all right?
I think he's scared.
Oh, don't be afraid, little one. We're totally harmless. Paolo is a Holtzin, and I'm an anteater. My name is Adriana.
Nice to meet you. I'm Min. And we should get you back to your nest. Your parents must be worried.
When I was a baby, I used to fall out of my nest 2 times a week. Of course, my nest was over the river. Back when there was a river.
The river always disappears in the dry season. But then it comes back. Only this year, it didn't.
But don't worry about that, little guy. Just do what Watsons do and climb back up. I'm okay.
Oh, no! His leg is hurt. Poor thing's not climbing anywhere.
He's not the type of bird that can climb anyway. But we could get him back up there. I just don't know how to get him past those howler monkeys. We're going to need some help. time to sound the Octo Alert.
Octo Agent Min, report please.
Min, are you all right?
I'm fine, Inky, but this baby bird is not. He fell out of his nest all the way to the forest floor.
That's a baby harpy eagle. They live way up in the treetops above the rainforest canopy.
His leg looks hurt. I need to help him right away.
That's not all. It looks like the rainforest is in trouble.
Indeed. The river has disappeared and the trees aren't getting enough water.
That's right. They aren't growing enough fruit and leaves for the howler monkeys to eat. So they've moved down to a lower layer where the trees are healthier. But now, the howler monkeys are chasing out the creatures who live down here and eating all their food.
It seems like there's a drought in the Amazon rainforest. The whole area is drying up because there's not enough rain.
Shiver me, whiskers! You can't have a rainforest without rain.
Sounds like we'll need all hands on deck and a gup that can handle all four layers of the rainforest. Tweak, maybe this would be a good opportunity to test the new gup somewhere that isn't the octopod.
You got it, Cap.
You and Peso head to the rainforest and meet up with Min.
And I'll go with them.
Are you sure, Professor? The rainforest isn't exactly octopus-friendly.
Aye, and you're more of a stay-at-home type of octopus. Or stay-in-the-library type, anyway.
I know I don't go out on missions very often, but if my friend Min needs help, I want to be there.
Understood, Professor. Join Tweak and Peso. The rest of us will search the area for other creatures that may need our help. Octonauts, to the rainforest!
Shush, 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 shush! I know you're scared, little guy, but you shouldn't squawk.
We try and keep quiet down here, on the forest floor.
Why do you need to keep quiet?
Because jaguars slink through the branches, hunting for tasty snacks, and it looks like I found one.
Wow, he's fast. Oh, no, we're trapped.
What's that?
That would be the Pterodup 5. I based it on a centipede. It can crawl over, under, around, and through just about anything.
Hello, Min.
Inky, what are you doing here?
You said I should see the rainforest for myself.
Don't be afraid, little one. There, all better.
Oh, my. He really likes you, Peso.
We still need to get him back to his parents.
I reckon the Pterodup 5 can handle the climb. Hold on tight. Pterodup 5 has powerful traps. They can grip down on the tree trunk or just about anything you want to climb.
Ah, here's where the river dries out, just like Min said.
Aye. It's all dried up trees, logs, and... I've got mud all in me boots.
Barnacles to Dashy, what can you see from the air?
We can see everything, Captain. There's not a cloud in the sky.
And that's the problem. No clouds means no rain in the rainforest.
From up here, we can see trees drying up and a long row of bare branches that should be leafy and green.
And look, that's where the river used to be.
We'll keep circling so we can see how much of the forest is affected.
Thanks, Dashy. This river brought water to a lot of trees in this part of the rainforest. Now those trees and all the creatures that live in them are in danger.
Cheaper, cheaper.
Thanks, matey. Just the thing I need to scrape the mud off me boots. I'll just take a seat on this log and...
Hey, get off of me.
Shiver me whiskers, a haunted log.
I am no log. I am Caesar the Cayman, sworn protector of this river, and I will defend it to the last. Or I would if I wasn't stuck in this here mud.
Hang on, matey. We'll have you out of this mud in a jiffy.
Chomp down on this cable, And hold on as tight as you can.
Oh, I can definitely chomp. We caimans have strong teeth.
Ready, Tunip?
Keepa!
Oh, at last! Oh, it feels so good to wiggle my toes again. Now, we just have to pull my friends out of the mud.
Friends?
Yeah, I have lots of friends.
According to my map of the rainforest, we've now made our way from the forest floor to the understory.
What's that?
Is it safe? Is the jaguar gone?
Oh, Octonauts, this is Paolo. Don't worry, the jaguar's gone.
Oh, thank goodness. I got so scared before I rang up the wrong tree. That's my nest, way over there. Hoitzins always build nests over a river. So if a predator comes around, we can just jump into the water. Of course, the river's gone now, so I guess I'm a little more nervous than usual.
Why don't you just fly over there?
Hoitzins are good at climbing and swimming, but flying, not so good.
Hold on, everybody. I got an idea.
Almost, but not quite.
Activating pincer claws. There you go, Paolo. Now you can walk straight home.
Thanks, Octonauts.
You're welcome, Paolo. Stay safe.
Speaking of safe, hang on.
Hola, I saw you had that Hoitzin. I was hoping you could help me, too.
We'd be happy to help.
Thanks. This way.
What seems to be the problem?
We red-eyed three frogs also lay our eggs over the water. That way, when they hatch, the tadpoles just drop down into the water. But now the river is gone. The understory is so hot and dry, and my eggs are about to hatch. There is nowhere for my tadpoles to go.
Flappity flippers. The creatures here need water, and fast.
I think I know who can help.
Tweak to Dashy. These tree frog tadpoles are about to hatch, but there's no water for them to swim in. And the rest of the critters aren't much better off.
Sounds like you need a rain shower.
This whole area is very dry. We'll have to circle all the way back to the river for water.
We'll pick up all the water the Octoray can carry.
And bring it to the creatures who need it.
Thanks, guys. Our friends are bringing water as soon as they can.
Oh, thank you.
In the meantime, we need to get this eaglet back to his parents. This is the canopy layer. The leafy green treetops. At least it used to be leafy and green.
I was afraid of this. Water has to travel all the way up a tree from its roots. So when a tree dries up, the top branches dry out first.
No wonder the howlers had to move down to the understory. There's no shade up here and nothing to eat.
This tree is too dried up, I'm afraid. The creatures here need to find a new home very soon.
But how can we help?
Oh.
Excuse me, are you okay?
Yes, I'm okay.
I'm sorry, but you'll have to find a new, healthy tree to live in. This one's drying out.
Yes, I know, but it's so hot. I'm too weak to move.
Dashy the Tweak. We're ready to stop the water drop.
Just in time. Okay, Dashy, drop away!
Oh! My babies are hatching! Oh!
Just like when I was a baby. Hey, little guys.
I haven't felt this good in months. I've got more than enough energy to find a new home. Look at me go!
It's working!
Even if we can't help all the trees, at least we're helping the creatures around here who need water.
Looks like we need to go and fill up with more water.
Thanks, Dashy. This should give the critters in this tree enough time to find a new home.
and we'd better get this little eaglet back to his home.
Harpy eagles usually nest in the emergent layer, the tops of the very tallest trees that poke up above the canopy.
Then let's keep climbing.
Uh-oh!
The branches up here are so dry and weak, they won't support the Terragup 5's weight. We'll have to use climbing claws the rest of the way.
I can't carry you and climb at the same time, unless... That's better.
I think perhaps I should stay in the Terragup 5. I'm not much of a climber, and I'd like to write down all the fascinating things we've seen while they're still fresh in my mind.
Okay, Professor. We'll be back before you can say bunch of munchy, crunchy carrots.
My trip to the Amazon rainforest has certainly been... Oh, my. Fascinating. And potentially very dangerous. Inkling to Min, the Terragup 5 has fallen all the way to the understory, and I'm currently surrounded by sleeping howler monkeys. Come to think of it, it's not like them to take an afternoon nap.
They must have worn themselves out chasing me earlier. You'll need to be very quiet until we get back.
Yes. I won't make a sound. Yeah. Oh, extraordinary. A screaming peer. The second loudest bird in the world. Fascinating. Oh, dear. Shh, go on. Shoo, shoo. Phew.
That's everyone. Thank you, Octonauts.
Of course, but maybe you should consider moving to a different part of the river.
Aye, a part that has water in it.
Yeah, you're right. And now, onward, my fellow Cayman, to the wet part of the river.
Let's check in with the Terragup 5 and see how the others are doing with that eaglet.
Oh, are you quite finished? Ah, of course. Those howlers must hear your screams all the time. They're quite used to them. Now, if it were a more unusual noise, like...
Cup K to Terragup 5!
Darcy, please speak more quietly.
Is that you, Professor? I can't quite hear you!
I'm in a delicate situation, and by delicate, I mean an entire troop of howler monkeys that, if awakened, could do great damage to me and the Terragup 5. Now, if you'll excuse me...
Professor, are you there?
Sounds like Inkling's in trouble. We'd better get there right away.
There. Turning off the radio should keep things peaceful around here. Oh, do be quiet. You'll wake up...
Hey! You can't park whatever this is here. This is our territory.
Oh, this tree is in danger. You need to find a new home.
But this tree is our home, and we're not leaving. So, with apologies, we must force you to leave.
Oh, dear.
With apologies, we must chase you away!
No wonder the little guy fell out of the nest. The branch underneath it broke, and the whole nest is about to fall.
Junior, we've been looking all over the rainforest for you.
Hello, we're the Octonauts. Our friend Min found your son on the forest floor.
He must have fallen. Your nest is in serious trouble.
I know. We were out looking for a new tree when Junior disappeared.
We found a tree, but it'll take a long time to build another nest.
You might not need to. Tweak to Dashy, we need one more little old favor.
Copy that, Tweak. We'll be there just as soon as we finish this last water drop.
Just a little more. Perfect! Thanks, Dashy.
Oh, this is wonderful! Such a beautiful, healthy tree!
Thanks for your help, Octonauts.
I say, Tweak, does the Terragup have an instruction manual?
It sure does, Professor. right below the console. Why?
I'm being pursued by some very persistent howler monkeys. I told them they had to move to a new tree, and they didn't take it at all well.
Keep them moving, Inky. Maybe we can lead them to a healthy part of the forest.
I agree. Moving seems to be the best plan. When traveling up steep inclines, make sure the primary graspers are engaged. Well, that goes without saying. You know, I think I'm getting the hang of it. Oh!
Hey! Why are you chasing us?
What? That can't be right.
After him!
You're doing great, Inky. Follow that branch to the next tree.
I'm afraid that branch doesn't quite reach anymore. But I have an idea.
Well, I'll be.
Brilliant, Inky. Now the howlers can run across to their new home.
Oh, but it will not work. We're not leaving. Now, with my apologies, we must once again force you to leave.
They're trying to knock the Terracup 5 out of the tree.
Leave our friends alone.
Fine. We know better than to mess with harpy eagles. Ooh, how dare you chase us into a new tree with more leaves and plenty to eat and, better places to sleep.
Maybe we should just stay.
Oh, right. Actually, we will take this tree, too. So, with apologies, it is ours now. So, I guess, thank you.
Mission accomplished, Cap.
The eaglet is safe in his nest.
The caimans are unstuck from the mud.
A lot of thirsty creatures have water.
And the howler monkeys have a new home, thanks to Inky.
Aye, but these issues are part of a much bigger problem that will continue.
Then we'll need to continue to check up on the rainforest and do whatever we can to help.
And now we know the Terragup 5 is the perfect way to get around this place. In fact, who's up for a quick tour?
That sounds like a wonderful idea.
You sure you know how to drive this thing, Professor?
Of course, Quasi. I read the manual. Now, hang on!